Hey guys, how's it going? Just wanted to show off my new ink that I got here. What do you think of that? Of course, I'm just kidding. It's all digital. Let's go inside of the computer and see how it's done.
Okay, let's start off here in Photoshop. This is where I made the tattoo. And so I started off with a flat color that vaguely represents my skin color, just to give me a little background so I'm not staring at these checkerboards. Then I made the actual text, which, if you don't know, says I love Japan. And made it a little bit soft around the edges. And then I thought it looked kind of boring, so I added a little bit of red around the edges and blurred that a little more. And so then I made another one and blurred that a little more. And then another one and blurred that even more. So then we end up with our freshly made tattoo with a little bit of redness. And that's about it. And we hide this layer and save it off as a transparent PNG. Okay, here we are in Mocha with the new project settings here. And all we have to do is choose our clip. Now I've exported my clip as individual frames. So I just click the first one and open. And I know that this clip is 59.94 frames per second. And then that's all we really have to do in here. And click OK. And yes, so that's just overwriting my previous test file. So here we go. We can use our mouse wheel to scroll through. Or we can just grab the timeline thing here and just drag. And so what I'm looking for is a spot where I can see the tattoo area really clearly and sharp. And I think that is around 350. Yeah, that's pretty good. Now, as you can see, I put these four dots on here on my arm. I used a little Sharpie marker for that. And you don't have to, but it really does help if you have something in there. So now let's come up here to our X-spline tool. You can also use a B-spline, but the X-spline, I like it a little better. So we'll just click in the corners around it. Doesn't have to be a square, it just works out that way here. And then I'll right click to finish it. And we're already on the track tab, or module as they call it. And so I'm gonna choose perspective because I know my arm moves a little bit in perspective. And keep everything at large motion. Luminance is good for a start. And then all we need to do is track. And since I'm in the middle, not at the beginning or the end, I'm gonna track forward first. And then I'll come back here and track to the end. And the tracking goes pretty quick. There we go, it's doing a pretty good job. Looks pretty smooth. And there's a little jump there. But overall, it's doing a pretty good job. Oh, now it looks like it may have gone off a little bit, but don't worry, we can fix that. Okay, now if I need to get back to where I started, we can see this little green mark that is a keyframe. And we have our keyframe tools right here. We have previous, next, add keyframe, and subtract. So I'll just hit previous and it jumps right back there. And then I'll just track backwards to the beginning of the video. And I'll go ahead and skip over this part so it's not so boring. Okay, so it's finished tracking. And can use the mouse wheel to scroll ahead. And we can see it's a little bit jittery here in the beginning because it's kind of gone sideways. And Mocha is a planar tracker, and my arm isn't exactly planar. So when it goes off to the side like that, it gets a little confused. But again, we can fix it. And yeah, up here you can see it's really stretched out. But again, we can fix that. Okay, let's just jump to that keyframe. Don't really need to, but it's a good starting place. And so now let's come up here and we will click our planar surface and show that. And so this is where your image is going to go. So I know that my image is sort of square, maybe a little bit rectangle. So let's spread this out a little bit more. There we go. That's pretty good. Can always adjust it later. Yep. And if you want to test that, you can come up here to Insert Clip, and we can put our 8x8 grid on, for example. And so we've got a checkerboard there, and you can scroll through and see how it looks as it rotates around, just to check the track and see how it's going. There's also a few other options in here, like the Mocha logo. But just go back to none for now. And so let's come over here to Insert. And this is where we will actually add our image. So the Insert Clip is not actually a clip, it's an image. So we'll go over here to Import and choose. And here is our tattoo PNG. Open that up. And the frame rate doesn't really matter because it's just one image. So we'll just click Import. And there it is. And so we can see it's on there. But it is not quite perfect. For one thing, it looks planar. It looks very flat, like it's a playing card stuck on there or something. So we can adjust that though. Let's come over here to this Warp tab and Show Mesh. And now we get a grid on there. And let's just lower it down to level 1 so we get less options here. Because we really just need to warp it a little bit. And we'll just drag the middle here up a little, just to make it kind of try to match the curvature of my arm. And that looks a little bit better. And so now let's try and go in and fix this weird stretching and stuff. So let's turn this mesh off. And we can turn this off. And come over to Adjust Track. And in fact, we can turn this off too, so it doesn't get in our way. There we go. And so now with Adjust Track, we get these four red kind of X's. And what I want to do is adjust those so that they line up with four points, in this case, the four dots. And let's hide the tattoo just with this P button up here. It toggles them. Preview. And so now everything's out of the way. And let's go back to that keyframe. It's a good starting place. And so I'm going to zoom in a little bit. And you would think to do this with the mouse wheel, but again, the mouse wheel scrolls through the timeline. So what we can do is either hit the magnifying glass up here, or we can hit the Z key to choose that. Or even easier, you can hold the Z key and just drag up and down. And then if you want to pan, you can hold the X key, or just what I like to do is use your middle mouse button. So anyway, let's drag these over to the four dots. Try to get it centered. And you can see the current frame shows up over here, so you can see more closely what you're doing. Okay, drag that one, and we'll drag that one. And then we're going to come down here to set master all. And so what that does is every time you scroll through, no matter where you are, you can always click on one of those and it'll show you what it originally looked like when you chose set master all. So now I've scrolled off and obviously the points have moved off from where they were. So I can just start dragging them back and I can compare the current frame up here to the master frame that I saved. And I'll drag this one. And that one. And then this one. And so you're basically just gonna scroll through the whole video and watch those to make sure that they stay on those points. Like I just see this one came off. So we'll just drag that back on. And we'll scroll through some more. And I see that one also dragged off here, or slid off. And you can see at this point, it's getting a little bit hard to see. So at some point, you're gonna have to just kind of guess where it is. Another way that you can move these rather than dragging them is just by selecting these corner buttons down here, and you can select one of each of the points. And then once you've got the one, you can use these left, right, up and down buttons to just nudge it like one pixel at a time. So it's really only good if it's very close because it can take a lot of clicks to get it right in the center. So that's basically it. We're gonna scroll through here and make all those adjustments, making sure they stay on the points as close as possible. And once it gets off the edge there, like I said, we're gonna have to guess a little bit. But yeah, I'll just go ahead and do that. And it'll take a little while to go through the whole thing, but I will pause the recording right here and I'll come back when it's done. Okay, so we're back, and as you can see, I've gone through and I needed to make a whole lot of keyframes in here just with each of the adjustments that I made for all of the different points. So let's see how it looks now. We'll hit the P and turn that preview back on, and I'll come back to track. And let's just click off of our layer up here. And so now I can see, and it looks pretty good. All right. So obviously I'm still zoomed in. So if I want to zoom back out, I can pick the magnifying glass or again, hold Z and just double click. And I'll zoom all the way back out. And so now let's come back to insert, the insert module, and make sure our layer is selected. And I'm gonna turn on motion blur. And then I can just start rendering with these over here. We can do one render with the cog in the middle and just see one frame just to see how it looks. And if it looks good, we can continue and render all the way forward. There we go. And this will actually take a couple minutes. So again, I will pause it and come back when it's done. Rendering from where I was, and we can see there's a light blue line underneath the timeline here to show what part has been rendered. So I'm just going to come and click back up here to just after I started the render, and we'll again render backwards from this point to the beginning. And again, this will take a few minutes, so I will pause the recording so you don't have to sit here and watch it. Okay, so it's all done. You can see the blue line has gone all the way across now. And we can scroll through the entire video. And there it is. In fact, I can click off of there so we can see it a little better. And there we go. That is a quick look at adding an image to a video in Mocha Pro. So, of course, this doesn't have to be just a tattoo. You could add any image to just about anything. So, if you think about it, you could add a sign on the side of a building, or you could add some graffiti to a box truck, or, you know, who knows, you could add some video clip to a tablet screen that someone's holding. So you can do all kinds of things with this technique, and it could be pretty interesting. What would you think of to do with it? Try to think of something and leave it in the comments below. So anyway, so now that you're done rendering, you can see that it will come up here in your folder. You'll find a results folder. And this is from my previous render, but here is all of our images. I'm just going to open this up with a good old free earfan view. And here it is, and we can click through all the images. And it'll take quite a while to click through them all. So especially while my computer's busy. But yeah, so there are your images, and you can load them up in your project. So have you thought of anything else you would do with this? Again, leave it in the comment below. If you liked this, please subscribe. I'm going to do more of these videos. So please like this video. Again, comment below. I'm on Patreon. If you feel like donating a couple bucks or something, you can find that in the description below. And be sure to subscribe, and I'll see you next time.